watching Special Miracles.
Can you believe it? This is really amazing. She was in a state of emergency, and now, all of a sudden, it appears everything is now normal. She can walk unassisted, as she couldn't do just a few minutes ago. According to Prophet Emmanuel Makandiwa, her life has been restored. This is unbelievable. But did you really note what the man of God said at the beginning of this service?
We may be seated before we can get into a moment of prayer. We are going to pray. You know, before this storm could attack,
Mafungo asata asimuka,
everything was already revealed to the servant of God. And all that they were supposed to have done was just to listen to what he was saying.
Truly, God reveals everything to his servant. It is evident that Prophet Makandiwa lives the future before it even comes to pass. In this case, he already knew about the storm in Mrs. Munemo's life. Under the prophetic unction, listen to what Prophet Makandiwa said.
Let me look at her, please. I can't see her.
Did he really mean he couldn't see her in the physical? Yet she was directly in his line of vision. Prophetically, the man of God was not seeing Mrs. Munemo in the spiritual realm. Her life was certainly in danger. Note that this is when the first miracle happened. She could now stand on her own as she started to walk. Although he could see her in the physical realm, he could not see her in the spiritual realm. Hence, by the power of God, he had to restore life to her.
You are healed, my sister. You can go back. You are free. You are free. Your life has been restored.
Just by a word from the man of God, life was given back to her. But what did she experience when the man of God was addressing her case?
I was being held up by the ashes because I could no longer stand. There was pain all over my body, both my sides and my feet. So Prophet Makandiwa said, "My sister, come."
This man of God called me my sister.
I thought the man of God called me his sister. I felt this love in his voice when he called me.
My sister, listen to me. Jesus makes you whole. Come here. Come.
So the moment I got to come, I felt power.
So the moment he said come, I felt this power coming over me, and I shook off the ashes that were supporting me. I wanted to walk on my own. I walked to where Prophet was. I was shocked to think just a few minutes ago I could not even walk, but here I am, after just one command, walking towards the man of God. I was surprised at how my body had responded to this command. God is amazing. So I walked towards the front, all the way to the stage, and I felt no pain at all. I could now lift my feet. Prophet Makandiwa said that I was about to miscarry, and truly I was about to have a miscarriage. The pain I had been experiencing was just too much. I felt like I had to push something out. That Monday, I had just come from the hospital. My amniotic fluid had been draining till the Sunday that Prophet Makandiwa ministered to me. Surely Prophet Makandiwa has a prophetic eye. I knew that God had remembered me through him. Prophet Makandiwa said to me, "My sister, do you know what? There's nothing that Jesus cannot do for you."
My sister, somebody died for this, so that you can be free. And Jesus is the solution. Jesus is the solution. Jesus is the solution. If Jesus can do it for her within seconds, as you are praying right now, any dislocation in your body, in your finances, in your marriage, as you are praying right now, a miracle is happening.
In spite of all the pain I was experiencing, the man of God is promising me there's nothing that Jesus cannot do for me. Does it mean that I'll get to hold my baby one day? Is this pain really gone forever? Is this what he means? He came down from the stage and stretched his hand towards my back. That moment that he stretched out his hand, I felt a movement in my back. I could feel that something was happening. I felt this power moving and I fell down. As I lay on the floor, I felt like I had been electrocuted. I was shaking violently. When I got up, I felt like something inside me had come out and I started vomiting. I was surprised because I had not eaten anything and I had no appetite whatsoever. I couldn't even drink water. As I vomited, I couldn't understand where all this was coming from. When I stood up, I felt that all was well and I could feel the baby moving in my womb.
Mrs. Munemo had suffered months of excruciating pain and suffering. All the medical treatments that had been prescribed so far had only provided temporary relief. So what happened after prayer? Had she finally found a permanent solution to her suffering? What happened to the mother and her child in the days that followed?
I really saw the hand of God. Before I received prayer, I could no longer eat. But now, I could eat without throwing up. Before that, if I tried to eat, I would immediately throw up. I could not retain any food. Even my health had deteriorated. I had lost so much weight because I wasn't eating. I thought that despite receiving prayer, the problems might just come back. But I soon realized that I had been healed for good. At times when I was sleeping, I would feel like someone was forcing food down my throat. I guess that's what I threw up when I received prayer. I would see someone giving me what looked like a root. They would tell me to eat it, and I would take it and eat it. This troubled me. I would wonder why I was accepting these things, yet I'm a prayerful woman. But you realize that God has a reason for everything. He knew that he would soon intervene through his prophet. Some say that pregnancy is enjoyable, and you should always enjoy the experience when you're pregnant. But I did not enjoy my pregnancy until I received prayer from Prophet Makandiwa. I only enjoyed the two remaining months. Everything changed radically. I could now walk, I could amniotic sweep the house, the amniotic fluid stopped draining and everything normalized. I was amazed to think that one could feel so free to walk about without experiencing any pain anyway. I really saw the goodness of God through his servant, Prophet Emmanuel Makandiwa.
Days went by, and the problem did not return. Normalcy had returned to their household. Even her husband was able to enjoy a good night's sleep for the first time in 7 months.
When I heard that Prophet Emmanuel Makandiwa prayed for my wife, I saw a change. That was the day I began to experience peace again. That was the day I had a good night's sleep again.
Before receiving prayer, pregnancy had turned Mrs. Munemo's life into a living nightmare. Nausea, lack of appetite, vomiting, and intense pain had become the norm in her life. Yet amazingly, after just one encounter with the hand of God, Mrs. Munemo's life changed radically.
Special Miracles will be right back.